Good afternoon, YouTube. X-File 2708 back again with another movie pickups video. Now, as you can see, got the new background. All very much work in progress at the minute. Got a big Billy bookcase directly behind me, which is where I'm housing all of my horror collection. I've got a temporary low IKEA bookcase to the side of me here. That's just housing what horror as well. What can I say? I've got a big horror collection. But that will be replaced with another tall Billy bookcase later on down the line. And then across over to this side, again, I've got a low bookcase and another tall Billy bookcase for all of my non-horror stuff. once I've got it together, a bit more how I'd like it, then, you know, I might do, you know, a little mini look around video. But for now, like I say, it's kind of a botch, if you like. I've got a little, I don't know, makeshift table down there. I've got another one to the side here with all of my pickups on. So if I have to pause this after a big crash that you hear, then it's the big pile of DVDs falling onto the floor. But like I say, it's makeshift for now. So, you know, over the coming weeks, then, you know, things will start to change and, you know, get a bit more permanent. So, where do we start? Right, these are charity shop pickups from last week. A trip across to one of the local towns with Ghost Lou at the weekend. So there was a visit to one of the local CEX stores. But I'll start with some pickups from the girlfriend last week. On the way back from work, she normally calls into one or two of the local charity shops for a quick mooch, and she managed to pick me up some DVDs, a Blu-ray, and a book. So, nice little haul. So, I'll start with the book. And the book, which I have never read before. I've seen the film twice, really enjoyed it. Obviously, the sequel to The Shining, and it is Doctor Sleep. So, never read the book for this one or The Shining, so I am looking to get the book of The Shining at some point where I can see it locally. In fact, that's, is that shadowing my face, isn't it? So, I don't know. Anyway, yeah, looking to pick up The Shining at some point where I can. I am going to have to move this bloody ring light in a minute because my face looks shadowed. Is it just because of? Fuck's sake. Get a grip, Marcus. Right, there we go. Doctor Sleep. Right, so I'm starting a pile down here. So hopefully we won't have any bangs and crashes. Right, to go with what I picked up recently, managed to get the original one of these from one of the local charity shops. Nice and cheap. So the girlfriend knew that that I was after the rest of them in the series. So she managed to pick me up Aliens. So special edition, this one. So apologies for the glare from the ring light. I will try and angle it as best as I can. So Aliens special edition. So hopefully got some interesting additional bits with it being a collector's edition. Original theatrical trailer, interview with James Cameron, behind the scenes footage. Includes over 17 minutes of restored footage as well. There we go. So yeah, I'm looking forward to re-watching that one. So I did re-watch the original Aliens recently, so this one's next on my list for a re-watch. Right. And then, as if by magic, there we go. Alien 3. Oh, excuse me, guys. I'm still a bit bloody sniffly from this cold. So, there we go. Alien 3. So, don't know if you can make out from the stickers in the corner, these were all 50 pence each, so not a bad price at all. So, Alien 3. Again, similar special features on this one, including the making of Alien 3. So, looking forward to checking that one out. And then we have Alien Resurrection, and I don't even recall if I've seen this one before. Can't remember. But yeah, I am going to work my way through them in order and give them a either first. Well, I've definitely seen Aliens and Alien 3. But yeah, don't recall Alien Resurrection at all. So there's that one. And then super pleased with this one. She managed to find me the original Friday the 13th, going back to 1980, I think it was. So was looking to pick this one up, hoping I'd find it in a charity shop as opposed to CX. I think it's a few quid normally in CX, similar to the Halloween franchise. You know, they tend to go for a couple of quid upwards, so always nice to find them in a charity shop and get them cheaper. So yeah, original Friday the 13th. Right, how am I going to do this? Oh yeah, the last one that she picked me up was a Blu-ray. So I haven't got too many Blu-rays since I've been recollecting physical media again, but I am picking the odd one up where I see them cheap in a charity shop. So myself and the girlfriend were out yesterday, so that pickups video is going to come probably later on in the week, I think. I've got some time, I might actually record it tomorrow and then release it later in the week. And on our trip yesterday, I did pick up three Blu-rays, so watch this space later on in the week. Absolutely superb film, this one. And it is Rutger Hauer in Hobo with a Shotgun. Now, I absolutely love this movie, so it was a great spot by the girlfriend. Really pleased she picked it up for me. I think I probably rewatched it a couple of months ago, but I've seen it several times over the years. I love the kind of grindhouse style that it's recorded in, and Rutger Hauer plays an absolutely superb part in it as well. So one of those, you know, not everybody has heard about. So, you know, what kind of put it out there as a bit of a unknown gem, if you like. So if you haven't seen it before, guys, it's not a massively expensive one, even in the likes of CX. So definitely, if you can watch it, whether it's on a streaming service or picking it up cheap on physical media, definitely recommend you giving it a watch. So there we go, Hobo with a Shotgun. Right, what should we do next? Right, I've got a big pile now of DVDs, mixture of horror, action films, comedy. Now, these were all ones that I picked up tail end of last week, it was. Myself and the girlfriend went out to one of these charity shops that's out in the sticks, kind of, you know, put in the middle of like a industrial estate. But it's a really big charity shop. Absolutely tons of stuff. It's got a cafe there and all of that sort of thing. But they must have a good couple of thousand DVDs, something like that. And they're literally 3 for £1, so just over 30 pence each. So I came back with, I think I worked it out, 21 DVDs that I needed. Like I say, good mixture across all different genres. And it cost me £7. You know, what can you say? Absolutely crazy prices at the minute, and all of the films are absolutely quality ones. I think, what are they? Maybe bar two of them, they're all ones that I've seen before. That I know are really good and that I'll re-watch again. So, first one, been looking forward to re-watching this one. Absolutely classic British film, and it is, there we go, Lock, Stock and Two Smoking Barrels. I haven't seen this for absolutely donkey's years. And this one is in that old style DVD case that they did when they first came out, the hard plastic. So yeah, really pleased to get this one. Obviously, Jason Statham's in there, Vinnie Jones, Dexter Fletcher, and this is the director's cut as well. So was super pleased to grab this one. I had been looking at getting hold of it the last few weeks, but just hadn't stumbled across it in any of the local charity shops. And I don't even think I'd seen it in any of the local CEXs, but as soon as I saw it in there, I grabbed it. So absolutely superb film, Lock, Stock. All right, put that one on there. It's like a little Jenga pile going on down there. So fingers crossed it doesn't all come tumbling down. Next one, and this is sealed. How on earth the person that donated this never opened it? I do not know, unless they obviously upgraded to the Blu-ray and traded it in. But it is the legendary Stanley Kubrick's Clockwork Orange. Excuse me. Absolutely amazing film. This one's in my, well, always, you know, if I'm asked to do a list of top 10 non-horror films, if you like, then Clockwork Orange always appears in my top 10. Absolutely amazing film. Probably saw it, don't know, maybe a couple of months ago was the last time I watched it. So one of those films I probably watch a couple of times every year. So absolutely love it. So there we go. Clockwork Orange, and still sealed. So super pleased to get hold of that one. Next up, one of the better remakes out there. Again, this was one that I rewatched recently on the Fire Stick. And as soon as I saw it, physical media DVD, I had to grab it for the collection. And it is the remake of Dawn of the Dead. Probably one of the best film remakes that have ever been done. So absolutely superb remake, this one. So if you haven't checked it out, guys, wholeheartedly recommend it. I am still trying to track down the Night of the Living Dead remake, which again is another excellent remake. So there we go. But for now, Dawn of the Dead remake. Next up, again, probably one of those films that I watch at least once a year. Absolutely love this one. And it is American Psycho. Old Patrick Bateman. So I read the book of this, actually. I'm going to try and get hold of the book again by Bret Easton Ellis. Absolutely. I mean, you think the film is brutal. The book goes into so much more detail. I mean, I was passed across the book by somebody else that couldn't stomach finishing the book and said, let me know what happens, please. I can't stomach reading any further with, you know, how descriptive it was over the way that he was, butchering people and things like that. So the book is amazing if you haven't read it before. So there we go. We have a bit of American Psycho. Right. Next up we have Snatch. Again, absolutely amazing British film. I don't know when this one was done. Was it in the 90s, I think it was? But again, Jason Statham, Vinnie Jones, Brad Pitt, Matthew Vaughn. Absolutely superb film. Similar to Lock, Stock, one that I haven't seen for donkey's years. So I am really looking forward to popping that one on again for a rewatch soon. So there we go, a bit of Snatch. Right, next one. Now, this was one that I watched a few years ago and I haven't seen it since. But again, it's one of those horror. Yeah, I'd say definitely more horror than thriller. One of those that tends to go under people's radars, but one I really enjoy and I'd recommend to other people if you haven't seen it before, guys. I think this is a Australian horror. But yeah, really good film, decent twist in it. I haven't seen it, like I say, for a good few years now, so it's what I am looking forward to rewatching soon. So, Cry Wolf. So, yep, superb film that one. And again, three for a pound. Can't go wrong. Next up is a Kevin Bacon film that I think I probably watched a couple of years ago, but I haven't seen it since. But it is one that I want to re-watch again. And it is Stir of Echoes. So see at the bottom there it says terrifying thriller. I don't remember too much about it, apart from remembering it was one that I enjoyed at the time. But yep, looking forward to re-watching that one again. So Stir of Echoes. And then we have, how we do for time? 16 minutes. Okay, we're probably halfway down, so not too bad for me. Absolutely love this film. Tom Hardy, and it is Bronson. So I probably saw this one a couple of years ago, I think, as a rewatch. Absolutely love it. Superb film. Absolutely brutal with it as well, as you can imagine from it being about Charles Bronson. But yeah, superb film again. If you haven't checked it out, guys, highly recommend that one. So there we go, Bronson. Next, don't need to say anything about this one really. It's the classic Goonies. So I am looking to pick up a decent amount of like the 80s classics. My good friend Clint, aka Retro Rewind, he's massively into his 80s movies and 80s nostalgia. So I've got Goonies, looking to pick up the likes of Ghostbusters, what else? Ghostbusters, Back to the Future, all of those sorts of films where I can. They crop up in the charity shops quite regularly, so hopefully I can get a decent library together of all the 80s classics. So there we go, we have the original Goonies. Next up, funny as fuck this one. Absolutely love it. You'll have seen recently I've picked up a few of the Jackass movies, so to go alongside it I had to get Bad Grandpa. So absolutely love this movie. Probably saw it, I can't remember, it might have been on the telly a few months ago. But yeah, never tire of watching this one. Really funny with the little kid and then Johnny Knoxville as the bad grandpa. So really funny that one. So there we go, there's Bad Grandpa, bit of comedy for the collection. So trying to mix it up a bit from, you know, I've got horror all in this corner, and then the opposite side's going to be all of my non-horror, my 80s stuff. I think I've already got the likes of Terminator, got those back in the collection already. So just need a few more hours in the day to start watching them all. So next up, we have Crank. Absolutely superb action movie with Jason Statham. Crank 2, absolutely superb as well if you haven't seen it before. But yeah, can't go wrong. Three for a pound on these. So Crank with Jason Statham. Next up, not sure if I've seen this sequel or not before. I've definitely seen the original, got the original over on the shelf units over in that corner. And it is 22 Jump Street. So don't recall if I've seen this one or not as yet. This copy still sealed. But yeah, 22 Jump Street with old what's his name? Jonah Hill and Channing Tatum. Absolutely loved 21 Jump Street. So yeah, looking forward to either checking it out for the first time if I haven't seen it, or giving it a rewatch. But yeah, a bit of 22 Jump Street. Right, that pile's getting a little bit wobbly now, so hopefully I can start a second pile. Right, next up, never seen this one before, so like I say, I think there's maybe three or four amongst these that I haven't seen. My dad's massively into his movies and movie collecting, etc. I mean, he's got a few thousand movies, so anytime I ring him for a catch up, nine times out of ten, we steer towards talking about what movies we've watched recently and things like that. And this was a recommendation from him, so I'm looking forward to checking this one out. And it is Hannah. So I've never seen it before, but it's supposed to be. I mean, it says on the back, it's a modern day Leon. But yeah, never seen it before, but yeah, it's come as a good recommendation, so hopefully get that watched at some point this week. So there we go, Hannah. If you have seen it before, guys, let me know in the comments if you enjoyed it or not. Now this one, complete punt on this one, but it's a one that's a, I don't know, an adaptation of Edgar Allan Poe, and it is Buried Alive. Now I've no idea on this one at all. I did try to have a look while I was in the charity shop, but you know, with these certain charity shops being in the arse end of nowhere, I couldn't get a signal at all. So, like I say, it was three for a pound, so I thought I'd take a punt on it. And it says Edgar Allan Poe's Buried Alive, starring Robert Vaughan and Donald Pleasance, John Carradine as well, so a decent cast. So I'm hoping it's going to be a nice little one that I've stumbled upon that I've never seen before and I will enjoy. So if you have seen it before, guys, again, let me know in the comments what your thoughts are on it, and if you think it will be a good watch or not. So there we go, Buried Alive. Right, let's start the new pile. Right, next up, a comedy that myself and Ghost Lou rewatched recently. Absolutely love this one. Big fan of Simon Pegg, and it is Run, Fat Boy, Run. So, you know, sometimes myself and Ghost Lou, we have movie nights, so we go out and we get some munchies, and I give him the choice of what film he wants us to watch. Last time I did, it was a rewatch of Run, Fat Boy, Run. So absolutely brilliant. I mean, it's kind of, I guess, classed as a rom-com, but with Simon Pegg, you know, any comedy's really good. You know, we like the likes of the Cornetto trilogy, you know, Hot Fuzz, Shaun of the Dead, and World's End, which we haven't seen World's End actually. So that is one I'm looking to re. Or not re. One that I'm looking to pick up soon. I have got it on the Fire Stick, so no doubt we'll watch that at some point soon. But yeah, Run, Fat Boy, Run, absolutely brilliant comedy, and one that we revisit watching quite regularly. Next up, one of my favourite comedies growing up. I think this was an 80s comedy. Correct me in the comments if I'm wrong, but it is Jumpin' Jack Flash with Whoopi Goldberg. So I haven't watched this for years, but yeah, growing up in the 80s, and you know, when I was enjoying watching movies in the 90s and 2000s, Jumpin' Jack Flash was always one that I enjoyed re-watching. So for me, this one's going to be a long overdue watch, but it never gets tiresome watching it. Absolutely funny as fuck, really good So there we go. Jumping Jack Flash with Whoopi Goldberg. So why is my, bloody camera came up saying AI HDR. No idea, I haven't seen it do that before, but right, next up, we recently picked up Kong Skull Island, so I've got that on the shelf over there. And I am looking to get all of the Kong and Kong versus Godzilla movies where I see them out in the wild with the charity shop hunts. But I managed to grab again 3 for £1 the special edition of Peter Jackson's King Kong. So again, I haven't seen this for donkey's years. I think I caught, when was it? Maybe 6 months or so ago, I was channel hopping and I caught the end of it. It was on normal telly. But yeah, really good film. Very, I think it's a really long film actually, isn't it? Isn't it like 3 hours long, I think it is. Yeah, 2 hours 59 minutes. And then the DVD extras run 3.5 hours. So there we go. So that can go alongside Kong Skull Island. So I think there's a new Kong versus Godzilla movie out at the end of, I think it's the end of this month. So looking forward to watching that one as well. And hopefully they've done a decent job of it. So there we go. Peter Jackson's King Kong 2-disc special edition. Now, I've got the joy after doing this video of putting these onto the shelf in alphabetical order because that's how I display things. So I do like making work for myself. Right, next up, absolutely love this movie. Watched it on the Fire Stick probably month. In fact, no, I didn't watch it on the Fire Stick. I watched the sequel on the Fire Stick for the first time a couple of months ago. But I've got the original Borat. Again, never tire of watching this one. Absolutely, really, really funny. So yeah, I think everybody knows what Borat is, so I don't need to say any more, but absolutely superb, like hidden camera movie. But yeah, superb. So pleased to add that one back into the collection. Right, next up, we have a bit of Adam's Family Values. So again, big fan of all of the Adam's Family movies. So looking to grab those where I see them in the wild, nice and cheap. So saw this one and grabbed it for the collection. So there we go. Next up, one hopefully I'm gonna rewatch this week actually with Ghost Lou. Massive fan of this one, and it is, there we go, a bit of a Ready Player One. So I think I've only seen this, I think from the start I've only seen it once before. I've caught the tail end of it, I think, when it was on the telly previously. But I was ready for a rewatch. So excellent homage to all of the 80s movies, this one. So a bit of Ready Player One. And one that I haven't seen this one in years, and it is, this is Spinal Tap. So I don't think I've seen this one for, when did it come out? I mean, this release was 2008, but I think it was a lot earlier than that that the film itself, the spoof documentary came out. So I don't know what year it was, but I seem to remember really enjoying it, and I know it's one that's always fondly talked about with people that enjoy the movies. So there we go. This is Spinal Tap. Right, and then the last one from the charity shop. So we're half an hour in, so I think I'm going to leave the CX ones that are on this pile here, and I'll put those on the video that's upcoming later this week. So for today, guys, the last one, and I was super pleased to find this one. It's a box set and it's absolutely pristine condition. I'm not looking at picking too many TV type box sets up, but when you see this one, you'll know why I brought it. And it is the Young Ones Complete Collection. So absolutely love myself some Young Ones Collection. I've again rewatched it. It's one of the ones that's on the Fire Stick. So I've gone through, I think I've watched the first three or four episodes lately, rewatching it. But yeah, never tire of watching the Young Ones. Absolutely classic comedy series. Obviously, Neil and Vivian, etc. Some great bands as well. I think I remember Motorhead doing a performance on one of the shows. So absolutely brilliant bit of Ace of Spades and the Young Ones. You can't go wrong. So there we go. That was £2. That was so. All of the other ones were £3 for £1. This box set was £2, and like I say, it's pretty much minty mint. So there we go. There. And then there, a bit of Alexis Sale on and he said in the background then. Alexis Sale on the back of the cover. So again, another series that I'm looking forward to rewatching through coming up. So there we go, guys. So we'll leave it there for now. So decent chunk of DVDs that I've picked up in the last week or so. Coming up later this week, obviously the pickups from when myself and Ghost Lou went out last weekend, and myself and the girlfriend and her sister went out yesterday. So again, I've got a full carrier bag of DVDs and Blu-rays that I picked up then. So all being well, I'll record that tomorrow and that will be released on the channel later this week. So there we go, guys. That's my video for today. As always, please remember to like, comment and subscribe. Let me know in the comments what your thoughts were, ones that you've seen before, if there's any there that I've recommended that you're interested in watching, picking up yourselves, etc. So there we go, guys. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll be back later on in the week with another video. Bye for now.